Performing arts like dance and the ballet help define American culture, and they can bring us together. And while diversity is increasing in this area of art, we still have a long way to go until we have total equality as far as access for those who want to learn how to dance or take part in a ballet. Tacoma is home to the Tacoma Urban Performing Arts Center, or TUPOC for short, and it brings a unique mixture of diversity and unity to the South Sound art scene.
It's always been my dream to be a ballerina, and I love TUPOC.
7-year-old Tara is living her dream, being able to be a ballerina in a large production like the Nutcracker. This Tacoma second grader is one of dozens of children of all ages who are taking part in the Tacoma Urban Performing Arts Center's, or TUPOC's, first ever production of the holiday traditional classic, The Nutcracker. Tara's father is one of many parents who are beaming with pride at seeing their children perform in TUPOC's multicultural production.
So it was a no-brainer, really, you know what I mean? It really celebrates who she is in terms of her culture, in terms of her identity. And I think in today's day and age, that's very important, and particularly for people of color, and especially for little black girls and little black boys.
Pamela Lewis Bridges is TUPOC's president, and she says this production isn't only about dance and art, but it also has its historical teachings as well.
Well, first off, we know the Nutcracker is a holiday favorite. Tchaikovsky, of course, being the Russian composer who has this glorious music around this wonderful fantastical story about, this Nutcracker doll. And I, as an educator, I'm seeing the literacy attached to this performance. So our young dancers, and actually some of our more mature dancers, are learning about this traditional Nutcracker story.
But as with every other art, there's cost that comes along with dancing. Costs that without programs like TUPOC would keep many of these children out of the ballet.
Everyone loves art, and everyone wants to see dance, everyone wants to see music, everyone wants to see theater. But no one wants to talk about the nitty-gritty of how we get there, and that support is money in so many different ways.
Along with this holiday production of The Nutcracker, TUPOC is also celebrating its recent move to Tacoma's Opera Alley from another downtown building that, among other things, wasn't even heated. TUPOC artistic director Karen O'Toole says this move was imperative for the future of this program.
It's so awesome. Opera Alley is just, first of all, adorable. And we have this incredible, just right off the sidewalk, you kind of waltz into this wonderful studio space, and it has wonderful natural light, and it has a real sense of being a place of learning, like a sense of being a school of dance. And I'm really looking forward to it. Plus, we have these wonderful sprung floors, which dancers really need to keep their knees healthy.
Diversity is the driving force behind TUPOC. Parents and students alike feel a common bond no matter what walk of life each individual dancer and their parents come from.
In any other ballet, the parents sort of drop their kids off. Here, you have more of a conversation, you talk about dance, you get to know each other, and you really reach deeply into the artistic community in Tacoma.
The future looks bright for this one-of-a-kind dance program for urban children. Along with diversity in art, children are also being exposed to educational aspects. Aspects that Pamela Lewis Bridges hopes will pick up steam.
I honestly know, without a doubt, especially as an educator, that many of our students have so much artistic talent. But with the push of STEM, meaning the science, technology, engineering, and math, we just thought we'd stick an A in there and push some steam in it. So we have science, technology, engineering, arts, and math.
If you'd like to learn more about the TUPOC program, or volunteer, or even help financially, you can do so by going to the website you can see at the bottom of your screen. That'll do it for this edition of Northwest Now Digital First. I'm Chris Anderson. Thanks for joining me.